Good afternoon. Late afternoon here. It's almost 1 o'clock my time. This is just going to be a very, very quick little follow-up video to the video on communism that the Lord had me to do last week. And that video, of course, will be in the description box. The video where we talk about communism, we show irrefutable proof that the Jesuit order were the creators of modern communism, and how they attributed it on to Jews, Marx and Engels, to use them as a scapegoat to get everyone angry at the Jewish people. But in that video, I mentioned to you about this thing called the Reducciones. Now, in the late 1800s is when the Communist Manifesto came out. We're going to see here in this article here, and also I'm going to read to you from another resource here, addressing this thing about the Reducciones, about how communism was in existence before Marx and Engels, and also that it was Catholicism that was the creator of communism. Now, as we said in the previous video, Thomas More, who wrote the book Utopia, he basically came up with the idea of this thing of communism. And here, the Jesuit order put the principles of that utopia into practice. Hence, this is before Marx and Engels, okay? But before we do that, I want to read to you a couple of verses of scripture. In Isaiah chapter 10, from the Authorized Version, verses 1 on to verse 4. Woe unto them that decree unrighteous decrees, and that write grievousness, which they have prescribed, to turn aside the needy from judgment, and to take away the right from the poor of my people, that widows may be their prey, and that they may rob the fatherless. And of course, that's exactly what the Jesuit order does. A link for the Secreta Monita audiobook will be in the description box. And also you can check out Brother Alexander Hartley's channel. He does an incredibly thorough rendering of the Secreta Monita. Okay? And what will ye do in the day of visitation and in the desolation which shall come from far? To whom will ye flee for help? And where will ye leave your glory? Without me, they shall bow down under the prisoners, and they shall fall under the slain. For all this, his anger is not turned away, but his hand is stretched out still. Then we go to 2 Peter chapter 2. 2 Peter chapter 2, verses 17 on to verse 19. These are wells without water. Clouds that are carried with a tempest, to whom the mist of darkness is reserved forever. For when they speak great swelling words of vanity, they allure through the lusts of the flesh, through much wantonness. Those that were clean escaped from them who live in error. And of course, you listen to all these stupid politicians, whether they're Republicans, conservative, Mr. Hunter, not the one from England. Mr. Hunter, I really enjoyed your one comment. Whether they be Republican, conservatives, or Democami libtards, okay, it doesn't matter. That's the whole thing of putting on the facade, all right? What do? The politicians. What do those who preach communism, socialism do? Socialism, communism. For they speak great swelling words of vanity. They allure through the lusts of the flesh, through much wantonness. Those that were clean escape from them who live in error. While they promise them liberty, they themselves are the servants of corruption. For of whom a man is overcome, of the same is he brought in bondage. And of course, I just have to. Romans chapter 6, verse 16. Got the natural tie-in with this. Romans chapter 6, verse 16. Know ye not that to whom ye yield yourselves servants to obey, his servants ye are to whom ye obey, whether of sin unto death or of obedience unto righteousness? Now, this is a link on Wikipedia. Gotta watch it with Wikipedia, but we're going to read some of this. The link for this will be in the description box, so you can look at it yourself. Here I'm using OBS, of course, and the print is very small. But bear with me here. I'm going to read a little of this to you, okay? Reductions. Spanish, reducciones. Also called congresiones. Portuguese, whatever. Were settlements created by Spanish rulers and Roman Catholic missionaries in Spanish America and the Spanish East Indies, the Philippines, in Portuguese-speaking Latin America. Such reductions were also called, I can barely see that, A-I-D-E-I-A-S, I'm not even going to try to pronounce that. The Spanish and Portuguese relocated forcibly, in many cases, indigenous inhabitants, Indians or Indios, of their colonies into urban settlements molded on those in Spain and Portugal. And remember, the book Utopia, written by, they call him Sir Thomas More, Catholic, okay, is what the Jesuit order, and Thomas More was before the Jesuit order, okay? But the Jesuits took that thing that Thomas More did and put it into practice. All right. The word reduction can be understood wrongly as meaning to reduce. Rather, the Royal Academy of Spain defines reduction as a grouping into settlement of indigenous people for the purpose of evangelization and assimilation. Ah, now, do you see that that euphemistic language there? Okay? When you think of reduction, what do you think of? To reduce, right? For example, you pour red wine into a pan, you turn it on to a heat, and then you reduce the wine, get the alcohol out, so you can begin to make a sauce, and then you add roux and whatever. Wonderful, okay? But no, just like Jesuitism, with their use of euphemistic language, okay, they change the name to change the condition, which doesn't happen, okay? But that's Jesuit. That's what Jesuit does. You look in the media here in America. They have been doing that for quite a while now, haven't they? And they do it right in front of your face to where it's just so blatantly obvious. But then again, no one cares because are you not entertained? Anyway. In colonial Mexico, they were called congregations. Congregaciones. I believe that's how that's pronounced. The goal of forced resettlements were to concentrate indigenous people into communities, facilitating civil and religious control over populations. You know what that kind of sounds like to me? It kind of sounds like the Holocaust, like the concentration camps, huh? Yeah. Remember, Catholics are Christians, and they really are. They really are. Okay. All right. The congregation of the indigenous into towns facilitated the organization and exploitation of their labor. The practice began during Spanish colonization in the Caribbean, relocating populations to be closer to Spanish settlements, often at a distance from their home territories, and likely facilitated the spread of disease. Reductions could be either religious, established and administered by an order of the Roman Catholic Church, Jesuits, church especially the Jesuits, or secular under the control of Spanish or Portuguese governmental authorities, which in turn, of course, were controlled by the Jesuit order. Okay? All right? The best known and most successful of the religious reductions were those created by the Jesuits in Paraguay and neighboring areas in the 17th century. The largest and most enduring secular reductions were those imposed on the highland people of the former Inca Empire of Peru during the rule of Viceroy Francisco de Toledo, 1569-1581. And of course, you look into that, who was pulling the strings there? Oh, that would be the Jesuits. Okay? All right? Now, let's read a little bit more of this. Like I said, yeah, you can read this for yourself. I'm going to leave the link in the description box for you. Okay. The policy of reductions was begun in 1503 by Spanish colonists on Caribbean islands. Now, 1503 was before the Jesuit order. In the words of the Spanish rulers, it is necessary that the Indians be assigned to towns in which they will live together, and that they not remain or wander separated from each other in the back country. You got to remember, the Spaniards were what? Roman Catholic. Okay? The Spanish ordered Indian villages to be destroyed and selected sites where new villages should be built. The concentration or reduction of the Indian population facilitated the Spaniards' access to Indian labor. The promulgation of Christianity, these were Catholics, okay? These were Catholics, okay? Okay? And the collection of taxes and tribute. Moreover, the reduction of the Indians was intended to break down ethnic and kinship ties and detribalize the residents to create a generic pan-Indian population, disregarding their numerous tribes and different cultures. So just like what you would read in Genesis 11 about how they all got together in the land of Shinar, traceable onto Babylon, Nimrod, and stuff like that, okay? Here we see Catholics wanting to bring everyone together to do what? To do what? Detribalize the residents to create a generic pan-Indian pan. Oh, like Peter Pan? No, like the devil pan? You know, the flute player Pan with the lower part of the, whatever he is, Pan, the god Pan, okay? All right, warning there. Pan-Indian population, disregarding their numerous tribes and different cultures. Satan wants to blend everything together. God is a god of variety. There is nothing kindredist of that. That is the way that God has intended it. He wants distinction. He wants variety. God is a God of distinction. One moment, please. One moment, please. Yes, my wife is doing stuff in the living room, and I'm in the... I'm not going to go there. In our brother Alexander's room here, but... God is a God of distinction. He set the bounds of the people according to their habitation. Okay? We cover that in a previous video on communism. Okay? But Catholicism, Jesuitism, wants to bring everybody together and blur the distinctions and stuff like that. God is against that in salvation. And see, this is what Satan, bam, this is what Satan blurs, okay? Salvifically, there is no distinction. There is neither Jew nor Greek, male nor female. We are all one in Christ Jesus. Salvifically, of course, if you come to the Lord on his terms, okay? But see, Catholicism, i.e. Jesuitism, wants to blend everybody together, get rid of distinction, and have one people. Why? To be ruled by the volition of a single man who will be that man of sin, the son of perdition, okay? Who will eventually be inhabited by Satan, okay? In North America, and of course, what did they do here in America to the indigenous Indian tribes? What did they do? The white man came and wiped them out, basically, and then what? They shipped them all on a train to Florida. And I'll tell you, there's an area in Florida called Arcadia, where you, when I've been in Arcadia, where you see Indians walking around with like mini swords on their hips. And, you know, hating someone for the color of their skin is wrong. But can't blame like the American Indian when they see a Japhethian around them for them to at least have a little. I mean, that's what people are taught. It's ingrained in people. When the Lord saves you, it's a different thing. It's not that we do not see distinction. Okay, I'd be lying to you if I said I didn't see the distinction in the kindreds. But see, as the Church of the Living God, knowing to whom created all things, applaud the distinctions. Rejoice in the distinctions. Amen. Hallelujah. There ain't nothing kindredist. There ain't nothing wrong with that, see? There ain't nothing wrong with that. All right? But let's continue. The Spanish began creating reductions in Mexico shortly after Hernan Cortes' conquest in the 1520s. They were begun in Baja California in the 17th century and California in the late, what is it, 18th century? Reductions in Mexico were more commonly known as congregaciones. And then, of course, we have the South America, and this, we're almost done with this. South America, main articles, Jesuit missions among the Guanar, well, I'm not even going to pronounce that. Indian reductions in the Andes, mostly in present-day Peru, Bolivia, began on a large scale in 1570. The Jesuit order was already created by then, and quite powerful already, I must add. During the rule of Viceroy Francisco de Toledo, Toledo worked to remake the society of the former Inca Empire. With some success, in a few years, he had resettled about 1.4 million Indians into 840 communities, many of which were the nuclei of present-day cities, towns, and villages. Probably the most famous of the reductions were of the areas of present-day Paraguay and neighboring Argentina, Brazil, and Bolivia in the 17th and 18th centuries. These were created and governed by the Jesuit order of the Catholic Church. Aha! Yes, yes, okay? But then again, you got to remember, Catholicism, okay, Catholicism was the driving force behind all these, okay? And then, what was it, the Jesuits came around in mid-1500s, but they became very powerful very quick, okay? All right? The Jesuit order nowadays is the ruling order in Catholicism. Today, especially today, when you say Catholicism, you may as well be saying Jesuitism, because the Jesuits run Catholicism. Today, most assuredly, Jesuitism is Catholicism. They are one and the same, okay? And let's read this last one. The Philippines and Micronesia, whatever. In the Spanish Philippines, the Spanish colonial government founded hundreds of towns and villages across the archipelago, modeled on towns and villages in Spain. The authorities often adopted a policy of reductions for the resettlement of inhabitants from far-flung scattered barmaos, I can barely see that, or barangays or whatever that is, to move into centralized cabecera, town, district, capital, where a newly built church and an town hall, whatever that is, you'll have the link for this, okay, were situated. This allowed the government to defend, control, and Christianize the indigenous population in scattered independent settlements, to conduct population counts, and to control tributes, and to collect, tributes. This enforced resettlement led to several revolts in the 17th century, often led by community shamans, close to Babylon, isn't it? In some cases, entire villages would move deeper into island interiors to escape the reductions. A similar policy was implemented in the nearby Marion Islands. Marion, named after, Trinidad, but Tobago or whatever that is. The Trinity, named after, okay? See the Catholic touch here in North America and in South America, in the original 13 states here in America, okay? You have Mary's Land, Trinidad, Tobago, or whatever it is, the Trinity, and then you have the Marian thing. Catholic! Okay? Catholic! All right? The link for this will be in the description box for you, okay, if you have any questions. Now, get rid of that, okay? Now I'm going to read to you a little bit from this book, The Enemy Unmasked by Mr. Bill Hughes. Mr. Bill Hughes is a Seventh-day Adventist. He gets a lot of the stuff in the book of Revelation wrong because he is a Seventh-day Adventist, but his work on the Jesuit order is very good. But I'm going to read you a little bit on the reductions here that he has in this book of his, okay? Now, we are going to read from where you see the highlighted to where my finger is here, okay? So, if you can, if you can, if it's clear enough, pause that, read it, pause it, take a snapshot, zoom in so you can read it yourself, okay? From finger to finger, above the fingers, okay? That's what I'm going to be reading. Or below, where the whatever. Quote, starting in the 1600s, the Jesuits created a communist regime in Paraguay that eventually brought the Jesuits' demise in the 1700s. The Jesuits, as is well known, held very large regions of Paraguay under missionary control from 1650 to 1750. More than 250,000 natives worked under their direction, and no payment was made directly to them. They were educated, trained, housed, clothed, fed, and to some extent amused. But what became of the surplus profits of their labors and of the extensive trading that was carried on? And see, communism. They trained them, they educated them, they fed them, they gave them clothes. David, hey, are you not entertained? Look at what's going on in America. Okay? The Democommies want to establish and have You look at what has been established through Hail Obama and all his nonsense and stuff like that. And hey, Republicans like Donald Trump, you know, what was that? Conservative. None of them are good. None of them are good. Okay, they're not. All right? There's nothing worse here in America than a Democommie and a Republican. But see, the Jesuits are using the Democommies the most, okay? All right? That does not mean if they decide to put in a Republican, you know, a conservative into office that it's going to, no, it's just going to get worse in a different way. You need to get your head out from betwixt your buttocks about this thing that is called politics in America, okay? It's a pro wrestling story angle, okay? George Carlin, who's burning in hell right now, he did have the right idea. Recognize what you are seeing as just entertainment and then withdraw yourself from that and watch the show, okay? And watch the show, all right? But see, communists, and you watch the video that will be in the description box, they say about elevating the lower class to the upper class, right? But see, communism doesn't clearly, at least in the manifesto, doesn't clearly define who the state is or what the state is. This is telling you what the state is. It's the Jesuit order. It's Rome. Okay? Yes, they we just saw here. They were educated, trained, housed, clothed, fed, and to some extent, amused. Muse means to think. You put an A in front of it, it means not to think. Amusement parks. Theists. They believe in a deity. Atheist. You get it? Okay? But what became of the surplus profits of their labors and of the extensive trading that was carried on? And what is that 2030 agenda that they're promoting? Own nothing and be happy? It's communism, which is Jesuitism, people, okay? Over 2,000 boats are said to have been engaged in carrying merchandise and goods on the Parana River, and the economic value of the reductions, communes, was beyond doubt very great. So great indeed as to have awakened the envy of Spanish and Portuguese traders. Robertson, oh, what an interesting choice of names there. Contemporary historian estimated that the reductions represented at least 25 million capital for the society. What society is that? Oh, the Society of Jesus, the Jesuit order. $25 million. The source here is Boyd Barrett, The Jesuit Enigma, New York, Bonnie and Liverite, page 211. Okay? The reductions were communist communities set up as manufacturing facilities using the Guarani Indians as slave laborers. The products they produced were sold in Europe and greatly enriched the Jesuit order. So see, the state gives to the lower class to get rid of the middle class, and then the state provides everything. The state provides what? Your education, warning. They train you, warning. They give you houses. They put clothes on your back. They feed you, and to some extent, they amuse you. They amuse you. That quote from the movie Gladiator is always, when it comes, America is the mob. Conjure magic for them, and they will be distracted. Take away their freedom, and instill their war, or instill their sports. The Jesuits give America entertainment. And our people love to have it so. They really do. And also in that quote from that movie, the bleeding heart of America isn't the Freemason Masonic document called the Constitution. Okay? It's not the marvel of the White House, the white outhouse. It's not the Republicans, the conservative Republicans, or the libtard Democommies. No. The bleeding heart of America is the entertainment industry. It's entertainment. Think about that. The news, the media, YouTube, BitChute, Disgusting Odyssey, Brighton, all these other waste book. Okay? Come on now. Quote here, and this is from Mr. Eric John Phelps, you know, whatever world that, whatever sphere of existence that guy's on. But the reductions produced herbs, hides, tallow, clocks, and other goods, which the Jesuits traded in Europe with their huge fleet of ships. The profits were used to finance wars against the Protestant nations they had sworn to destroy. But all this wealth and power was acquired in secret, as the kings of Portugal and Spain knew nothing about the reductions. Eric Phelps, Vatican Assassins, Halicon Unified Services, page 189. And of course, if you look into buying a book form of the Vatican Assassins, that thing can cost upwards to $1,000. I wouldn't even give that man $5. His information is good, yes, but I wouldn't give that man $5. But there's a little information for you about the reducciones, okay? And again, people, you got these people who are going to come around to blame shift and say that it was the Jews that created communism. Roman Catholicism created communism. The Jesuit order are the ones who brought it to perfection. Hence, they created the communism that you see today. Okay? It wasn't Marx and Engels. Okay? They stuck that on to them so you of the world would hate the Jews. And the Jesuits are using that as fuel to bring the whole world against the Jewish people. Okay? All right? But that was just a little on the reductions. I had said that I was going to do this video last week sometime. This week, whatever. And I never did. So here you go. All right? Like I said, just going to be a quick little video for you to consider. Check out the links in the description box for more information about this. People, Roman Catholicism and Jesuit order is your enemy. Okay? Rome is your enemy. It doesn't matter who you are. It doesn't matter. Okay? Rome is your enemy. Please understand that. Okay? That'll be it for this little video. See you later. Bye-bye.